Hovertech. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to unroot a Samsung Android device. Now, I don't know what technique you use to root, but the most reliable way to unroot is to flash back the firmware. Now, if your model is NOx protected, that means rooting must have trip NOx. So, unrooting is very much unlikely to untrip NOx. Now, I'll link to a guide on how to determine the right firmware to download in order to unroot your Samsung Android device. And we'll be unrooting using the firmware and Odin. I also link to a guide on how to set up your Samsung drivers and to use Odin. So now first you launch Odin. And then like BL, you load the BL file. Under AP, you load the AP. Now it depends what you load after CP depends on what you intend to do. Now, if you intend to retain your data, you just load home CSC and you stop there and you are good to flash. But if you want to do a clean wipe, then what you do is you load regular CSC and then you can load user data depending on your version of Odin and the availability of this file in your firmware. So I want to do an unroot and a clean wipe. But if you don't want to do a clean wipe, you just select home CSC and you stop there. Now, sometimes when you try to flash without doing a clean wipe, it might require a factory reset. It might or might not. So it's always good to just back up your data when you try to reflash your firmware to your device. I should also mention that when flashing in Odin, avoid flashing only the AP partition because sometimes it might resize your user data partition. That might happen to you. So I just prefer to flash a full firmware when I want to unroot. So I'll go ahead and boot into download mode. I'll link to a guide on how to do that and commence flashing. And then you click start. I should mention that for old Samsung models that have just AP in the firmware, you load only AP and flash that. All right, so flashing is done and you can now, the device is going to boot up. So that's how to unroot your Samsung Android device by flashing the firmware.